All right, you two, a band known for classic hits, electrifying performances, and heartfelt humanitarian work around the world. But it was this moment in Nashville Saturday night that had us all thinking just how cool these guys really are. You say you give me eyes in a moon of blindness, a river in a time of dryness. Well, that's Arizona's Adam Bevel on stage with Bono, one of 45,000 fans that packed Vanderbilt Stadium. But in the end, he had the best seat in the house. Heck, he was playing to the house. So how did he work all that out? Adam joins us now live from Phoenix this morning. Okay, Adam, so first question, do you have the sign with you?
I do. I have it right in front of me, actually.
Okay, let's see it.
My brother-in-law made the sign for me as we were standing there. We borrowed a piece of paper and a marker from some fans that were just kind of down the way. And he was reluctant at first to make it for me, but I convinced him, and it was always my dream to be able to get on stage. And you know, he made this sign for me, and I held it up throughout the concert, and at the very end, he finally called me up.
And just to give our viewers a little background, you lost your vision, or you started to lose your vision in your early teens, right? What happened, and then how did you start playing the guitar and develop this love for you too?
Well, at age 14, I found out I had a rare eye condition called retinitis pigmentosa, and doctors told me that I'd be blind by the time I got out of high school. Well, I didn't really, I kind of beat those odds a little bit, and at about 28, it got to the point where I had no usable vision anymore, and so it kind of went on from there.
So you continue to play guitar, obviously. You've got some serious skill. And Bono saw your sign and said, okay, let's bring him up stage. What did he say to you when you got up there?
Well, first they finished their song, their last song, which was called Moment of Surrender. They had ended all the concerts with that song. And I kind of started to drop my sign, and all of a sudden I heard Bono's voice. What do you want to play, man? And I thought, there's no way he's talking to me. There's no way. And my brother-in-law kind of leaned to me. He's talking to you. What? You know? And I yelled out, all I want is you. And the fans started yelling it as well. And he said, get this dude up here. Let's get him a guitar. Let's get him my guitar. So I just thought it was. And before I knew it, I was on stage and being for me the best part was when Bono came over and grabbed my hand and said, come this way. And he kind of led me through the obstacles on the stage. And it just showed to me his kindness and his patience. And for me, that was the greatest thing, because it just showed what a great person he was.
Indeed. And you picked that song in particular, right? Because you wanted to play it for your wife.
Yeah, I did. It's our song. So I always thought, you know what, if I ever got on stage, I was going to play that song and dedicate it to my wife, and I could not believe that happened. I mean, I've dreamt it a million times, and it was better than I ever would have imagined.
Well, it was pretty amazing, Adam, and you've given the edge a little competition. I know Bono is actually sending you the guitar, and so I know you've got your acoustic guitar. If you don't mind, will you play us to break?
Sure, absolutely.
Let's do it. Adam Bevel, next to go on tour with you too, and we'll be there.
To the seekers of things which are